Today's topic is fundamental rights and direct principles. First of all, what is the meaning of the right? We discuss about the rights. What is the meaning of the right? Right means having something. Right means having something. For example, if we have a property, it was called as a right to property. If we have a culture, it was called as a right to culture. If we have a education, it was called as a right to education. If we have a family, it was called as a right to family. If we have a freedom, it was called as a right to freedom. If we have a religion, it was called as a right to religion. Finally, right means having something. Why? What we have, it was called as a right. Next, inspiration. Inspiration of our fundamental rights, the Magna Carta 1215 of England. First inspiration, the Magna Carta 1215 of England. Then second one, the Bill of Rights 1791 of USA. Second inspiration, the Bill of Rights 1791 of USA. And third inspiration, French Declaration of Rights 1789. Third inspiration, French Declaration of Rights 1789, have inspired Constituent Assembly of India. And also, the fathers of the Constitution were inspired by Universal Declaration of Human Rights. Fathers of the Constitution were inspired by Universal Declaration of Human Rights, which was adopted by the United Nations Organization General Assembly on 10th December 1948. The 10th December was called as the Human Rights Day, the Universal Human Rights Day. Finally, the fundamental rights are the part of third that our constitution is spirit of constitution. Spirit of constitution. Then features. Features of fundamental rights. Generally, some features had a fundamental rights. First one, rights are available to all citizens of India, irrespective of their caste, color, gender, etc. Rights are available to all citizens of India, irrespective of their caste, color, creed, religion, territory, gender, etc. And second one, these are gestible in nature. The violation of fundamental rights are gestible. If we have a violation of our fundamental rights, higher judiciary branches, namely High Court, Supreme Court, or Jilla Courts. They secure our rights and protect our rights. So these are the justiciable. And third one, fundamental rights are essential for the development of individual personality and human dignity. Third one, essential for the development of individual personality and human dignity. And fourth one, some of the fundamental rights are negative in nature. They protect individual from violation of state. They protect from violation of the state. Some of the fundamental rights are positive in nature. Some of negative and some of the positive in nature. They provide scope to avail freedom. And another feature, these are not absolute. Some reasons, restraints may be imposed by state to protect the nation and individual freedom.